more of this. Final Fantasy. Hello. Hi.
The world is on fire. What have we done?
Uh-oh. You told me some stuff to do, but first I need to actually find a place. Oh, there it is. That was fast.
Need to find a... Oh, right there.
All
right, okay.
So your suggestion was swaps Kane into the location and remove all of Cid's gear.
Yeah, it's really hot down here, and he's getting a little overheated, so he should just, like, drop everything.
Which also means I can upgrade some of Cecil's gear, which means he won't be able to heal as well anymore.
Well, you can also give Kane that fire shield.
I could give Kane that shield.
Now that you have a dedicated healer, Cecil doesn't need to be the super cool backup white mage that he was. So he can just put on the Mithril gear if you want him to.
I mean, I don't think I had much... Oh, I have a Mithril shield, that's right.
Yeah, you got one from Kane.
And a Mithril helm.
But if you want to leave those two things on, because the shield does have dark damage, it's not a bad thing.
You need dark resist.
Whatever. I said half Stark, whatever. Something like that.
You said something about... Oh, I didn't hear the halves. That's what it was.
Has, have, you know, stuff.
You know, considering, that will probably be useful. For, you know, whatever reason.
Plot. Are you guys ready for more plot? Because it's coming.
Here comes the plot. Hoo boy. Wait a minute, is everybody full in health? We're not.
Oh, well, no. I lied.
Whatever. I'll just heal, and then only Cecil will be missing some MP. I don't know how that happened.
Like, that's literally... level gains, running through the Lodestone Cave.
Yep. Ollie-ho.
Ah, these guys are the best.
Alright, there are some cool items I should be picking up here.
Nothing you can pick up yet.
Alright. Oh, Luca lost her dolls.
Yeah. That's great. That won't become a plot point in about pay no clock.
King Dwarf. Hello.
Everything from the dwarves in 9 is a direct reference to these guys, and I love it.
I mean, a lot of what these guys do is a direct reference to the dwarves from 1.
That's true. I don't know about the Lolly-ho thing.
Yeah, I think they did that in 1. At least they did in the remake.
You know, I think they put that in the remake because of this, and I think the dwarves are also in 3. The dwarves are around.
Dwarves. Damn, Golbez moves fast. Are the crystals okay? 2 are gone already. The fuck?
Wait a minute. We just blew a hole, the only hole we could think of in order for them to get down here. How did he do that? Yeah, I know, they actually do the airships come down through the Tower of Babel, but, or Babel, or whatever it is, but, shh, we're not supposed to know that.
Bye, Cid.
Yeah, Cid actually brings up a point of why he couldn't fly over the magma. He needs to have mithril plating on it for it to work.
Just came up with that immediately. I love it.
Well, it's probably one of those things where I could put the mithril plating on it, but the only thing it does is it's really useful with, you know, heat prevention and stuff, but I don't need to worry about that up here. Okay, here we go.
This boss.
The ones in the front are very fragile. Okay, sorry. I thought that was a let me give you advice thing. If you want to, have fun.
I need to wipe once.
Okay.
There's the dolls, they're doing the thing. I mean, the one thing I'll ask is, do they do the thing where if I kill all of one type, they fuse?
Yes.
I don't see how you're supposed to prevent that.
Well, if you kill all of them at once...
I have thoughts.
Oh, the music.
Do they have any elemental weaknesses?
Nope.
Okay. Oh no. Okay, they don't have a lot of health. Alright. Okay. I have a plan. Fuck! Piss! 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 Wait. Wait. We're good! Whew! I did it.
Well done.
For those that don't know, if you fucks up, like I almost did there, they fuse into a much bigger doll. That's extremely rude.
Yeah, the bigger doll can hit you for 1k damage easily.
Without any fucking rest, here we go. I'm trying to go to the moon, Cecil. Here we go. The big man himself.
I'm sure you'll be fine.
I'll be fine. Yeah, I'll just use a cure on Rosen, get her back up. Ah, the good shit.
If you're really quick, you can get Kane in the air here.
Ah, there's the real Dark Dragon.
Yep.
Yeah, Black Fang. There you go. There's the really rude move. You want to kill that Dark Dragon before it does that.
Yep. But Crumb, you say, why is it important to have Kane in the air? Because he doesn't die.
What the? And Eidolon.
Really goofy looking dragon.
That voice that I shouldn't recognize because she's way fucking older now. Okay, here we go. The real fight starts.
Oh god, everyone's dead. What do you do?
Damn it. I hit swap rows. Alright, well, the first turn doesn't count. Good times.
That's the best. So,
this fight is extremely rude.
This is a rude fight. You need to get Shell up ASAP on both your people. And also have Rydia, for the love of God, get Rosa awake.
Oh, fuck yes, he used Osmos. I will take that. Oh, fuck, he can really fucking use Osmos.
Yes.
Fuck it, Dry Aether. Can you cast Raze? You can. Fantastic. Dual cast Raze and Cura. Welp. I could not get healing off.
Probably more important just to have Rose get to full HP before stuff happens.
Noted.
So have Cecil throw a Phoenix Sound on her and then Rydia immediately use a high potion.
Motherfucker!
Yeah, Shell's also not a bad idea.
Okay, he just attacked.
Okay, Rose is up.
Okay.
Yeah. Man, that's a great point someone brings up in the chat. Hey, don't you have an item that inflicts slow?
Motherfucker! Gobez, calm the fuck down. Alright, let's try this again. Dual cast raise. Cura.
Get it off?
Yep, okay, everybody's up. Light magic. Shelga. Focus. We begin charging the Yang train.
Yang does not have an elemental weapon equipped. That's good.
And let's just, you know, for good measure, double cast Akira. Whew, let me tell you about doing this fight without double cast.
Let me tell you about doing this fight on hard mode. First move on hard mode usually one-shots Rydia. So all you're doing is trying to get everybody up with Cecil, who you need to have two rounds go by with him, not just wrecking someone.
So
it is a lesson in frustration.
Oh, good. He's still covering still covering Rosa. That's nice. Oh. Sorry, I'm not used to having summons. So when the screen cut away, I got real confused. Oh god. That heals him now.
Yeah, he has a random elemental barrier, but he's always weak to holy.
No, he's not.
Oh, really? Good to know. I think you can scan him and it'll tell what he's weak to. Or you can just punch him in the face a bunch.
Cecil doesn't have an non-elemental weapon.
Oh, that's because Kane has the thing. Just have Cecil always on healing duty.
What's the scan item?
No, cast Libra.
Oh, right, that's a spell.
Yeah. Have Cecil always on Libra duty. There you go.
Analyze target. Is he going to tell me?
I think you can then look at him after you've analyzed him and it'll tell you what he absorbs. Like if you're trying to target him.
Weak to fire.
There you go.
Summon Ifrit.
And then you'll probably have to go through the same song and dance again.
Fine by me. So far this is working. Still getting Yang up to health. I love it.
Yeah, this is where Yang's rather low magic resist starts to bite him in the ass.
Suplexes rock into Golbez's face. Target analyzed. Yeah, so he does absorb other elements. Absorbs lightning currently. What just happened?
What?
Oh, I defended with radio by accident.
Man, if he ever gets weak to Holy, Yang's gonna tear him a new one.
Oh, does the fairy calls on Yang do Holy?
Pretty sure it does.
Piss. It means I can't actually attack with Yang.
Just keep him ready to go. This is Rydia's show.
At the very least, we can keep having, Kane jumping.
Yeah, Kane can do nice damage overall. Cecil, if you want him to, can be doing little pity hits, but it's better just to have him on Libra duty. So right after Rydia hits him with an elemental spell, Cecil casts Libra right away.
I like Ramu, but with a gun. Oh, he's dead. Oh, yeah, it was just that recovery that was intense. Holy shit.
Yeah, the whole fight's about getting yourself back up on your feet. If you're lucky enough to get Kane in the air at the beginning, it's much easier to recover because you've got two pretty durable people that can start doing some healing right off the bat. And also Rydia, who's made of wet tissue paper.
I like, because it's a canned animation, when Kane has a sword, he, like, spins the sword really goofy.
Yeah. Oh, trust me, it's about to get even more amusing.
Oh, who is this mysterious traveler?
Hi, Rydia. Welcome back to the party, buddy. I have missed you.
We almost got the whole gang.
Mm-hmm. What are you talking about? This is the best team you're ever going to have.
It's sad, but true. Alright, we're just going to leave. No need to fucking, like, do anything with Golbez's body. No,
yeah,
fucking
guys.
Just...
Double tap. Double tap.
You idiots. You stupid morons. Oh, wait, no, we're coming back. Bye. Fuck. God. Ah. I'm sorry, we're morons.
That fight's, it's a lot more creepier in the SNES version because he says, death will not claim me, and then his body disappears except for a hand that crawls along the ground, and you just kind of watch the hand slowly creep over, it grabs a crystal, and it disappears. And I'm sitting there going, use your sword, chop that hand in half. What are you doing?
All right, tell me there's some side quests that I can do and we don't have to go immediately to the sealed cave.
Oh no, there's plenty of stuff between us and the sealed cave.
Oh, thank Christ.
You don't go to the sealed cave until you have your end game party, technically.
Oh, okay. Oh, I know what's next.
Yeah, you're going to go to the tower.
No, the actual other thing that's next.
Yeah, we're going to go talk to some fun people. You have that 40-page or 40-step list on hand, right?
Nope.
Good.
I want you all to have this. Draw attacks augment. Nice.
Yes, 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 yes.
Tell me this one's passive.
Yes. You put that sucker on Cecil and he is ready to go.
Alright, well, it's actually a couple. Wait, the fuck am I supposed to put Whirlwind on?
No one yet.
Okay, good. Alright. So, draw attacks on Cecil.
Yep.
Bluff on Rydia.
Fast talker on Rydia.
In death, Tell will stay with you, Rydia.
By teaching you how to be, you know, awesome. Also, some 5-year-old kid you'd never met taught you how to cast spells even harder than before.
Alright, so here's the problem.
What's up?
Can't fucking remove items.
Yeah, so take off her attack command.
I suppose.
Her main command should be bluff.
Yep. I really wish you could remove the item command.
It's useful enough to have.
I understand why.
Yeah, there's sometimes it'd be nice to have a couple people who don't need to worry about using items. Their whole job is to do other stuff.
Alright. Are there items here?
Oh, there's so many items you need to wander around and find. One of them is a really good upgrade for Kane.
You know, maybe... Yeah, we'll see how long exploring this place takes.
Oh, quite a while.
Because then we might leave the other thing.
For off-screen?
No, just for the next episode.
Oh, I think that... Oh, yeah, I think you can do all of this before we finish up here tonight. There's enough stuff to do. Yeah, the pub is where you go to get to the developer school.
I found it.
Yeah, okay. All right, we're doing this thing.
We will leave that for later.
Yeah.
I was just looking for items. We will do items first, and then we will do that. I have heard that it is a thing. Alright. You know what? Weapons and armor.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything you need to buy. Oh, by the way, you need to check out Rydia's gear. Oh, I lied. There is something you need to buy. I think you need to buy a rune armlet for Rosa. Newbie?
I'm here.
Oh, sorry. It froze for a second on the... thingy.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Rydia comes with a gold hairpin, a luminous robe, and a rune armlet. She is set for like the next forever.
Yeah. Stream is having a little bit of problems.
Don't worry about buying anything for Yon or Sid or Sid. Kane or Cecil. Yeah.
Do I want to buy dwarven axes?
No. You will find one in this place.
Do I want to buy two? Or at least one?
Nope. By the time you get to the next place, you'll find better gear for both Kane and Cecil. So it's not worth it to buy another dwarven axe.
Okay.
Cecil can do just plenty of work with his fire sword now, or he can do decent work with... if you want to give him the sleep blade again.
Oh, there's the axe. There we go. I believe stream has now stabilized. Give him that axe. Yeah, we'll give him the sleep blade back.
If you want, you can actually give Cecil the axe, and you can keep Kane with the sleep blade, because now all the enemies are having all their attacks drawn to Cecil. He's going to get hit, and he's going to turn around and whack him.
Oh, I don't think I adjusted that.
Yeah, you need to put draw fire on Cecil.
Also, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah, Cecil doesn't need anything anymore that's called speed and electric spirit. All he needs is strength and stamina.
What do I remove?
Cover? He doesn't need cover anymore because he's already drawing all the attacks.
That's a good fucking point. I didn't even think about that. I'm like, but what about other people? He's gotta cover them. He is.
Yeah. He's doing his job.
Welcome to our fucking urn room. Is there anything in these urns? No. We just made a room with a bunch of urns.
Well, they're the urns of all the dead dwarves. Oh, now you feel bad.
Something bad's gonna happen when I open up this chest.
Nothing bad. Actually, there are no trap chests in the castle.
None of them aware of trap chests again. I trust no treasure.
I was about to say, I promise I won't tell you a chest is not trapped when it is, but then I realized, no, I'm totally going to do that to him at least twice. Because I'm a jerk.
There's a power armlet.
Yep.
Slap that on Cecil.
Yeah, that works. I would have said Yang as well.
Yeah. Which explains why you told me not to buy the rune armlet. You know what? I'm going to put it on Kane.
Sure. It's probably not a bad idea because Yang is having issues blowing up whenever he gets hit by magic. So having that rune armlet on is going to help him, you know, for a substantial amount of time.
There's just the four items in this room, right?
Yep.
Okay. Anything else of import?
Not in this tower. You got to go over to the other tower.
Okay.
The big thing now for Cecil is he needs to just anything that boosts his defense and attack, that's what you put on him. Him being a spellcaster is pretty much a day of the past.
Yep. Pretty much. That's what I figured. That's why I was like, I'm not going to put it on him because I want him to have the highest defense that he can.
Mm-hmm. Because since he is drawing all the attacks to himself, he's going to get hit a lot.
I was going to ask, why is the inn underground? Then I remember dwarfs.
You're already underground.
There's a cross. Remove curse. Yeah, give me 10 of those.
Yeah, curse. You'll never run into that.
Yo, fucking give me some more Phoenix Downs. I went through my supply, it's crazy.
Yeah, you fought a jackass of a boss. By the way, you went through the West Tower, you did not go to the top of the West Tower. Because you went straight to the end.
Yeah, I'm
okay.
Gonna go back.
Just double check him. I want to make sure you don't miss all the sweet gear.
I need to stay for the night.
No, you actually don't.
Okay. I wasn't sure if they were nice or not.
There is a very nice thing at the bottom of the castle on your way out. There's a healing pot.
Is the basement where I go to continue?
Yeah. You gotta talk to some dwarf next to a wall and he'll be like, okay, you got the right of way, and he'll open the secret door that you take to get to the basement.
Alright.
Well, the second basement. There are a lot of basements. It's a dwarven castle.
And this is the entrance. Okay, so time to go back to that tower.
Pretty much. Yeah, you just saw that dwarf when you were said, alright, this is the entrance. Time to go back to the tower.
Pretty much. Alright, yep. What's good? What's good in this tower?
I think there's some pretty sweet gear for Yang in here.
That's weird. Dwarves, known for their martial arts. there it is. Alright, I missed a chest then.
Hmm?
I said I missed a chest then.
How so?
I said I did not find any gear for Yong.
It's on the third floor of that tower. If you found a potion, an ether, and elixir.
Yeah, I missed it.
Yep. Keep looking around.
I now have it.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Why do I...
It makes him better at, like, you know, everything.
Right. I was like, why don't I have the like, a better thing than the headband on him? And then I remembered that fucking... The headband boosts his attack a bunch.
Yeah, it's made for him.
Alright, are we done here?
I mean, we're done with everything, save for going to the developer's office.
Alright, time to go to the developer's office. Do you have a list?
I'm getting there right now. Alright, I'm ready.
Alright, I gotta remember how to get there.
It's in between the weapon and armor shop.
Right, I gotta remember where that is.
It's on the right side of the castle.
I found it, okay. Alright, developer room.
Alright, first things first, just so you know, at some point on this floor, you're going to need to go into a random battle with Game Designer. Just turn on the auto battle and eventually you'll be okay. But first things first, as you enter the room, you should talk to the dwarf and the guard. The dwarf's name is Kango and the guard's name is Namiya something 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 Yamamoto.
The dwarf and the guard?
After you've gotten into the developer's office?
Yeah, I'm in here. I don't see a dwarf or... I got into a random fight.
Oh, they got that.
I'm fighting a Gundam.
Alright, well, whatever. Enter the main area and talk to the blue creature, Yoshioka? Blue creature.
Okay. You said auto battle's good enough for this? My prayers go unanswered. I didn't know prayer could fail.
Yeah.
I had a moment of like, why is Cecil getting beat up so much? And then remembered, oh right, draw fire.
But look at him chunk that guy every time he gets hit.
Give my regards to Matrix. Alright, so the blue guy.
Blue guy.
Alright.
And then go northwest, which is the left and up, and talk to the doll.
Alright, does it matter what I tell these people?
No.
Okay. Have I been opening treasure chests? Hell yeah, I have. Thievery's a crime. Now I face the consequences. I'm a chocobo.
Neat.
This is goofy.
Mm-hmm. Did you talk to the doll?
The doll? Not yet. Got anything to drink? Do I just beat up this tiny baby?
Go for it.
Or do I give it, like, an item?
No, I... What, I have no idea. Try to give it a potion or something.
I'm just gonna beat it up.
It's the wrong guy.
Pardon?
I'm reading through this and somehow it's... seem right.
Are you reading because the remake has a different developer room?
I think I might be reading the iOS version.
I just let this go and I... Oh, that's it. I won. I did it.
Whatever. Just talk to everybody.
Yeah, I said talk to everybody. It'll be worth my while.
Yep.
What?
What?
I walked into a guard and he fell over.
Whoops.
You're gonna pay to fix it, right? No. I'm now fighting this guard. I wouldn't mind all these joke fights if they didn't take forever.
Yeah. I wonder if they changed it for the...
For the what?
I wonder if they changed it for the version you're using compared to the normal one. Whatever. As long as you talk to everybody, you'll be fine.
I don't know. What do you say we call it a draw? Wait a second. Nah, you fucked up. I actually need to wait for this guy. He's complaining every time I punch him.
Oh, good.
This is alright. I killed him. He's dead. He's actually gone.
You monster.
Nobody else died. Alright, what about you? Guy's really happy that he's good at odd jobs. Oops.
What?
Yeah,
Oh, did you run into a bunch of people who wanted to try something out?
Oh, shit.
Like a team of four people, perhaps?
No, I did something way worse.
What?
Okay, can I not game over in here?
You cannot.
Okay, thank Christ. I just got scared shitless. Do not tell the girl that you don't think she's pretty.
Yeah, stop doing that. Just say yes to whatever these people say.
That one was an accident. Oh, because white isn't... Because there's that thing, white. It's not in this version, right?
Yeah.
I got into another random encounter with the same fucking idiot. Can I just run from this?
Probably. You've already beaten him once.
Good. I walked into the sound room.
Uh-huh.
This black mage who is lamenting over his meal choices. I feel him. I feel his plight. Alright, I'm in the break room now.
Yeah, the guide I have is very different from the place you're at, so I think they changed it.
Maybe. Just in case, I'm gonna heal everybody up. Oh, because this is the smartphone version.
It is? Okay.
Yeah. I'm fighting Skarmiglion. Oh wait, Skarmiglion uses what status effect do my characters have right now?
Curse?
Yeah, it is curse. What does curse do?
I think it just lowers your effectiveness in what you do. Like two-thirds damage or something. You just get wrecked?
Yeah. With protect up.
Yeah, might be one of those unwinnable fights.
Yeah, I think this is unwinnable. Because he deals like 4k damage. Okay.
Yeah, the battle system fight in the DS version, you fight four people and they just utterly destroy you. So it's probably the same deal here.
I hope I enjoy the rest. The reach augment. Nice.
Alright, that's all you needed to do here.
Who do I give that to?
No one in your party.
Ah, okay. Well,
it goes on a chump.
What's our, status looking like? You have to use anything? Cool. I think that's a place to call it.
Alright then. Like, for the night?
Possibly.
Well, if you do that, you might as well get through to the basement and get to the other side of the dwarf castle and call it there.
Okay. I didn't know if that was long or not.
No. There's no fights or anything. You just walk through there, you can find a couple chests, and that's about it.
Alright, that sounds good. We'll call it after that. It's mostly I'm still recovering a bit.
Oh yeah, I gotcha.
I feel like sometimes I see hidden walls where there should be anything.
Don't worry about it. It's fine. You're not seeing anything at all. You're perfectly normal.
I found Geshel Greens.
I think if you talk to the dwarves, they say, when you say you're talking about the great, the fat chocobo, they call him something like the gold bird or whatever. He's like a minor god to them.
Nice.
Yeah. Why? Who cares?
I felt like there was going to be something hidden over there in that little, like, corner.
No. Nope.
Cottage. There's a bunch of cottages. I'll take it. Did you say it was a healing urn down here?
Very end.
Alright. Next time. Is tower?
We climb a tower.
Another one.
It is, it's gonna be fun.
Well, until then.
See everybody.